A tree map sounds like a strange name for a chart. So, exactly what is a tree map? In simple terms, a tree map chart is a colorful, organized way to show the different parts of something, their sizes, and how they relate to each other. A tree map chart provides a visual representation of hierarchical data where each branch of the hierarchy tree is given a colored rectangle. The size of each rectangle is determined by the value it represents, thus providing an effective way to visualize the proportion of each category within the hierarchy and how it contributes to the whole. Tree map charts are used in various fields, including finance, business, and data analysis. Our company sells snack products to gas stations in 5 states. The data in the worksheet shows our profit for the week. A tree map chart will give us a quick view of the distribution of our profit for the various products across the 5 states. When we look at the chart, we can see that each state category has its own grouping. If we add up the profit for all of the products we sell in each state, the state of Indiana has the highest total profit. The categories are sorted left to right based on their combined item values. The category with the largest combined profit values appears on the left, which in this case is Indiana. The rectangles within a category are sorted by size, starting with the largest in the top left corner, progressing down to the smallest in the bottom right. It is important to note that it doesn't matter what order you have entered your data in as far as size is concerned. Even though Florida has the smallest amount of profit, it could have been entered at the top of the data. What does matter is that all of the data for a group must be together. In this case, all of the Indiana data needs to be together, all of the Illinois data needs to be together, and so on. If it isn't, the rectangles pertaining to a category will not be together. Since the largest value in the spreadsheet is 1,000, this item will be represented by the largest rectangle. I will first convert the data into a table so that we will be able to later filter what is to be displayed in the tree map chart. Now we can select the data for our tree map chart. It is important to note that you should not include your column headings when selecting the data for your tree map chart. I will click on the Quick Analysis button. I will select Charts. The tree map chart doesn't appear here, so I will click on More. I will click on the All Charts tab. I will select Tree Map in the left pane. I will change the chart size. The largest rectangle represents the largest value. Because the most profit came from Illinois muffins, it has the largest rectangle. When you change data in the table, it is automatically changed on the chart. I will change the value for Illinois donuts from 300 to 600. Let's do some formatting. You could change the look of the chart by selecting one of the chart styles. You could also change its look by selecting a different color palette. I will select Colorful Palette 3. It is usually easier to read a tree map chart if you convert the headings, which in this case are state names, to banners. Right-click any one of the rectangles on the chart, and then select Format Data Series. Select Banner from the label options. I want the profit values to appear in the rectangles. To do that, I will click the down arrow for chart options in the Format Chart Area pane, and then select Data Labels. This adds another option button, Label Options. Click the Label Options button. I will select Value. I will select New Line for the separator, so that it places the label and value on two separate lines. With the text selected for each state and product, I will change its color to black and increase its size. I will increase the size of the legend. I will change the chart title and make its text bold and italic. I will click on the table's filter button for state. I will remove the check marks for Florida and Georgia. These states have now been removed from the chart. I will click on the filter button for profit. I will click on number filters. I will select greater than or equal to. I will enter 300 for the value. No items with a value of less than 300 now appear in the chart. I will clear the filters for profit and state. It's important to note that any formatting that you have applied to the chart, other than changing the chart style or its color palette, will be removed if you apply a filter. The formatting will be removed even if you clear the filters. Therefore, you should make your formatting changes after you have applied any filters that you want to use. If you want to apply formatting to an entire group, you can click on the legend for that group, click on the Ribbons Format tab, and click on Shape Fill. When a group of rectangles or an individual rectangle is selected, you can change its background to a different color, gradient, picture, or texture. I will change the background for Indiana using a different method. Clicking once on the chart selects the entire chart area. If you then click on one of the rectangles, that category and its heading will remain the same, but all the other categories and their headings will be dimmed. Now that the Indiana group is selected, I will apply a texture to it. I will click on the down arrow for the fill button. I will select Texture, and then I will pick one of the textures. All of the Indiana rectangles, including the banner header, have had a texture applied to them. Once a group is selected, you can click on an individual rectangle to select it, or you can select another group by clicking on its header. Be careful that you don't click on the text in a rectangle, because if you do, everything will be selected. I will click on the donut rectangle under Indiana. You can't see it when a category is textured, but if it were a darker color, you could see that the other items in the category are dimmed when an individual rectangle is selected. I will click on the down arrow for the fill button. I will select Texture, and then I will pick one of the textures. I will click on the muffins rectangle in the Indiana group to select it. I will select a different texture for it. I will click on the outside of the chart to deselect it. I want to fill the Georgia rectangle with a cookie picture. I will need to click on it once to select the chart, and then two more times to select the individual rectangle. I will click on the down arrow for shape fill, and then select picture. I will click on online pictures. I will enter cookies for the search. I will select one of the pictures and then click on the Insert button. I will click on the Florida rectangle. I will right-click on the rectangle and select Fill. I will fill it with the color yellow. I will add a green border to it. I will click on the Outline button and select a green color. I will click on the outside of the chart to deselect it. I will click on the Chart Design tab and then select the last chart in the Chart Styles group. The selected chart style replaces all of the rectangles that I hadn't formatted. To make the rectangles more distinct, I will increase the border width between them. I will right-click on one of the rectangles and then select Outline. I will select Weight. I will select the largest weight.